If you can convince yourself that you are helping someone by stigmatizing them and locking them up, this is a piece of misinformation that's going to be not overcome in 24 hours or 48 hours or 48 months. And this is what people have to come to their own realization. As Learned Hand, the great American judge, said a long time ago, doesn't matter what laws you bring, people have to change in their heart. We really have to look at history seriously. Slavery was abolished in 1865. What was the condition of black people in America when I came to America in 1938? During the Second World War, the troops were still segregated. That was almost 100 years after the Civil War. The laws have changed, but people's hearts have not changed. It takes a very long time. I hope it's not going to take another 100 years in the case of psychiatry. But that's why it's important. That's why I look upon CCHR as virtually the only abolitionist organization. The term I have used for almost 50 years is what we need is psychiatric abolition, because what we have is psychiatric slavery. It's a complex business in that there is a continuous, very powerful counter voice from organized psychiatry, the drug industry, the government itself is a continuous propaganda machine for more and better psychiatric coercion. That CCHR has certainly been effective in informing enormous numbers of people about this, and also arousing a great deal of resistance to this, is clear. I am happy for CCHR, but I am very sad in a larger sense that it's the only group that has had the guts to stand up against psychiatric power. There is nothing else that I'm aware of anywhere in the world. And certainly no organization with the clout that CCHR now has. Individual responsibility, in my opinion, is the only value that's superior to liberty. That is the most important thing in human life.